There are people who live in the community where I am at. When I tell them I work in the Everglades, they say, what's an Everglade? They really don't know, have no idea. I've been here since 92. When my wife and I came down here permanently and I saw an ad, the volunteers wanted, I had a choice of either sitting in a rocking chair and waiting to die or do something constructive. And I chose to do something constructive. This is just an area that's, wildlife is the important thing and people are just visitors.
Loxahatchee is surrounded by development that is quickly pressing in on it. And it's the last remnant of the Everglades in this part of South Florida. Anybody who visits, lives, passes through South Florida needs to understand a lot of us who live here and work here get our drinking water from here.
Even people that live 5 miles away from it don't feel a relationship to it. In order to get people to care, it has to do with really sort of understanding that place over time and really understanding that you're a part of that place. You're not something separate from it. These kids are growing up probably less than 10 miles away from the most iconic wetland ecosystem in the world, and yet some of them have never seen it. And that's important because this is their water.
Seeing school kids come through that know nothing, that are afraid of butterflies and dragonflies and ants, and it does my heart good to help them see what nature is like. There is no other Everglades like this in the world. It's beautiful to me.
A lot of people don't even realize that they've got a piece of the Everglades in their own backyards.
When I see a smile on their face, when they seem interested, what automatically goes into my mind is, wow, we've got maybe a future Fish and Wildlife Service employee on our hands. And to me, that's extremely important.